आज इस वर्ष के समारोह की दूसरी संध्या है। भारतीय विद्या भवन की स्थापना 1938 में महात्मा गांधी के आशीर्वाद से कुलपति के एन मुंशी द्वारा की गई थी। The aim of the trust and the society is to serve and promote the best of our heritage in terms of culture, classical music, performing arts and education. From humble beginnings, it has grown into an institution of national eminence and has by now a pan-Indian presence. It has 120 centers within India and 7 overseas, including London and New York. For the services rendered by the Bhavan, it has been recognized by the Government of India as an educational institute of national eminence and is the recipient of Communal Harmony Award, Rajiv Gandhi Award for National Integration, and above all, International Gandhi Peace Prize. अपने 73वें स्थापना दिवस के अवसर पर भारतीय विद्या भवन ने संगीत समारोह की शुरुआत की, जिसमें आज तक देश के श्रेष्ठतम कलाकार भाग लेते आ रहे हैं। इस मौके पर भवन द्वारा एक ऐसे वरिष्ठ कलाकार को भी संगीत शिखर सम्मान से अलंकृत किया जाता है, जिन्होंने शास्त्रीय संगीत या नृत्य के जगत में बहुमूल्य योगदान दिया है। हम अपने स्पॉन्सर्स को भी इस मौके पर धन्यवाद देना चाहेंगे। आर स्पॉन्सर्स दिस ईयर आर स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया। हमारा सौभाग्य है कि आज हमारे बीच मुख्य अतिथि के रूप में उपस्थित हैं वैदिक काल, बुद्धिज्म और भारतीय कला के प्रख्यात विद्वान ICCR के भूतपूर्व अध्यक्ष प्रोफेसर लोकेश चंद्रा। मैं प्रोफेसर लोकेश चंद्रा और भारतीय विद्या भवन के निदेशक श्री अशोक प्रधान से निवेदन करती हूँ कि दीप प्रज्वलन के लिए आप कृपया मंच पर पधारें। हमारे बीच जानी मानी समालोचिका और लेखिका श्रीमती लीला वेंकटरामन उपस्थित हैं। मैं आपसे निवेदन करती हूँ मंच पर पधारें और श्रीमती दीप्ति ओम चरी भल्ला से निवेदन करती हूँ आप कृपया मंच पर पधारें।
प्रोफेसर लोकेश चंद्र जी का स्वागत करता हूँ। आज इस अवसर पर आए हैं हमें कुछ बोलकर आगे बढ़ने का लिए उत्साहित करेंगे और एक पुस्तक का भी विमोचन करेंगे। धन्यवाद।
आपका बहुत धन्यवाद। संस्कृत एंड संस्कृति हैज टेकन अप द चैलेंजिंग टास्क ऑफ ब्रिंगिंग फोर्थ सेवरल टेक्स्ट ऑफ संस्कृत ऑन म्यूजिक डांस एंड ड्रामा through Bhavan series of Natya, Ritya and Sahitya. The series has received wide acclaim. This year Bhartiye Vidya Bhavan has come out with Sangeet Parijat of Ahubala. Sangeet Parijat of Ahubala is a Sanskrit text on music written in the 17th century. It introduces many aspects of southern music in the north, making it an important text of Hindustani music. Pandit Bhatkhande described the text as one of the most popular Sanskrit works of the North. And I request our chief guest, Professor Lokesh Chandra, to kindly release Sangeet Parijat of Ahubala. Before I request him to speak, a few words about our chief guest. Professor Lokesh Chandra is a prominent scholar of the Vedic period, Buddhism and the Indian arts. He was the president of ICCR. He is also the director of the International Academy of Indian Culture. He has served as a member of Rajya Sabha and chairman of the Indian Council of Historical Research. He has been honored with the Padma Bhushan. He has to his credit over 360 works, which include Tibetan Sanskrit Dictionary and Dictionary of Buddhist Art in about 20 volumes. It is an honor to have you with us this evening, sir. May I request you to kindly speak on the occasion?
India's Independence Day. India had won independence, but it lost in that independence at soul. There was one Indian who thought that the soul was more important than political freedom. That was K.M. Munshiji. His charming wife was equally enthusiastic about the great cultural traditions of India. Munshiji wrote, Jai Somnath. India's assertion that we have been an independent nation, we continue to be an independent nation, not subservient either to any culture or to any domination, political or economic. Something, you know, culture is a very important aspect of life. In this context, I would like to remind my friends, the president of China, Xi Jinping, if you read his book on the art of governance, he quotes Chinese inscriptions, Chinese dynastic history, quotes the great statesmen, political thinkers of China, because China's polity, even during the days of Chairman Mao Zedong, was deeply influenced by the Chinese concept of politics. China, the central kingdom, and the world around the barbarians. The question of barbarian. Actually, the word barbarian is something Chinese. The Chinese character means beard. Chinese didn't have beard. The other Central Asian people and others, they had beards. So if you look at the character, not the meaning, the character is for a beard. But ultimately, it also carries the extended semantics of a barbarian. Why is a barbarian? Unless you respect your culture, unless the culture inspires you to action, it can only do so if it is you are the centrum of that perception. So the whole idea of this great Bhartiye Vidya Bhawan, started by Munshi, who wrote the Jai Somnath, had the Jai Somnath temple constructed again. Something, you know, unthinkable in that year in which it was constructed. President did not get presidential escort when he went to inaugurate the Somnath temple. Still Munshiji insisted. So we not only saw in him a politician or a writer, but someone with a deep conviction of India's future and India's historic evolution. I don't talk of history as just something of the past, but history as a personification of a nation's beauty, of its great ideals, What is our ideal? Freedom of thought. In Sanskrit they say, munde munde matir bhinna tunde tunde vashu bhinnam. Every mind has another thought. Difference of opinion doesn't mean that we are antagonistic to each other. We are opposites, we are not opposites. Macho bhinnam tunde tunde vacho bhinnam. And everybody has a right to say what he feels. You know, great dictum of India, the freedom, the openness of the mind. Something which has, you know, now perhaps again come up again in India in a very brilliant way. So the Bhartiye Vidya Bhawan has for the last 70 years been contributing to the enrichment of India's cultural personality besides giving education to children, where each and every religion is respected. But that doesn't mean that I disown my religion. That has to be very clear. Respect for the other religion doesn't mean that I disown my own. What is mine, but I respect the others because of the alterity of the other perception. So the great work that Bhavan is doing is something which India needs and will always need for many centuries to come. So I'm very happy that Bhavan celebrates the great musical tradition of India. India, you know, is very interesting because Chinese music, for example, was enriched by Indian music. For the first time when Indian music went to China, the prince Sanjeeva took the music, Indian music to China. Chinese music was pentatonic, but he introduced the heptatonic music in China. And the Buddhist music in China, where they sing Sanskrit in Chinese way. And when the World Olympics was held in Shanghai in 2008, it began with the singing of a Sanskrit hymn, but in the Chinese style. It was done perhaps in heptatonic music, I don't remember now exactly. But you know, the whole tradition, music tradition in India is so rich. There are so many texts. And the Bhavan, for the first time, has not only arranged these ceremonies, but they are bringing out beautiful books. These books will carry the message of India's musical message across the world. People who are interested in the history of music, people who are interested in India, because our microtones are something very new to the Western music. So these books are as important a part of the Bhavan's activities as the functions themselves, the physical, you know, the audio visual presentation. Thank you, friends. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. It was released yesterday. I request her to kindly speak on the occasion.
That I've been very fortunate in editing about 5 very important texts on Indian music, starting from Brihadesi, Sangeeta Ratnakara, Sangeeta Darpana, Sangeeta Parijata, and Manasulasa. All these texts, some of which of course are known to many of the scholars, researchers, and even those who are connected closely to Indian arts. But some of the texts, like Parijata and Darpana, even Manasulasa, are not texts which have gained that much of popularity as perhaps Sangeeta Ratnakara, because that is a complete Lakshana Granthas. But the fact that Bhartiye Vidya Bhavan took up this challenge of bringing forth such texts which were perhaps not in the interest of an ordinary readership is, I would say, a very commendable and a very challenging, a very difficult task that they have undertaken. And I have been constantly motivated by the director, Ashok Pradhanji, because many a times I felt it was not, I could not perhaps complete the work that was assigned to me, but he was all the time motivating me that you have to do it and you can do it. And perhaps it's because of that I've been able to complete the 2 books, Sangeeta Ratnakara, Brihadesi, and of course Sangeeta Parijata, which have now come out in the book form, with a lot many articles, I would say, written by not only well-known leading scholars who have dedicated themselves to the study of such granthas, but also young researchers who want to know, go deep into some of these texts, and for whom I'm very sure that these books and the journals will give them a very good guideline to how to go about finding what they actually want through their research, in their research work. I'm very grateful to Pradhanji and Bhartiye Vidya Bhavan for giving me this opportunity, and I'm sure all of you would like, you'll find this book and other digests interesting. Thank you.
In just a few moments from now, we will begin with our first recital this evening, violin recital by Sushri A. Kanyakumari. We request you to kindly put your mobile phones on silent mode. Thank you. violin, Sri Ramesh Chandradas, and flute, Sri Srinivas Satpathy. Ladies and gentlemen, Odissi by Sujata Mahapatra.
ni bada ni 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 Dalisa 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 sa sa Sagare sa ni re sa ni da sa ni da ma ni da ma ga da ma ga ri ma ga ri sa ga ri sa sa sa
Ni na ni na ni na ni na ni na ni na ni na
Sagama gama dha mada ni dhani sa Sa re sa ga ni sa ni ni sa ni re sa ni dha mada ma ni dha ma ga re ga re ma ga ri sa
Tom.